As we go into the monitoring tab, we're able to see much more information about our system and what is taking place there in a simple visual manner. Here in this dashboard page, we see a general overview of the system based on the time range defined, which may be modified as per the needed. Here we see our available gateways, the ones that are actually active with SD-WAN, and we'll see more information about them a little later. Here, VPN tunnel information in case overlay is being used, and we can select the view details to get a more detailed view on the tunnels up, down, and per gateway. The steering objects shows which steering objects are actually in use within our SD-WAN policy. In the link swaps, this shows general number of swaps that have taken place in the system from one ISP to the other as per the time range defined. More details can be seen, but we'll see this later in the live monitoring. Next, as suggested, we have overall SLA or status of our gateways and their links for the time defined. We have different colors, which represent the different information about our links. And here in the info, we can see what this each color represents. As we dive in further, we can really see the state of each one of our gateways as per the color and for the time. Lastly, going back, we have the top applications per traffic. This gives us some overall idea as to the applications in use in our system, and this can assist us in understanding what additional rules may be created to perhaps enhance our SD-WAN policy. In order for this section to be displayed, log sharing must be enabled. Now, as we proceed on to the live monitoring of the system, here we're able to see the different live information per gateway. We can select for which gateway, define which steering behavior to examine, at this time only for local breakout, and we can define the time for which we'd like to check, and here we'll do the last 24 hours. As we've selected, Cluster A is the gateway for us to see. We'll see different information around it. Here on the right, we'll see our general throughput for each of the ISPs or WAN links based on the colors. Below, we see the latency, the jitter, and the packet loss. The dotted lines which we see are the inactive ISPs, and the solid line are the active ones. The red dotted line, as suggested above, is actually the threshold defined per steering behavior. In case we're using link aggregation, all of the lines will be solid unless not meeting the criteria and being above the threshold defined. Here we see various swaps from dotted to straight or to solid, okay? And these are the link swaps which we see taking place between the various ISPs. As suggested earlier, here on the left-hand side is the additional information, and we can see the time, the gateway, which steering object, from which link to which link, and the reasoning behind it. And if we look at clusters, we're also able to see on which member the actual swap took place. As we see here, it was on member 1 of HQ1. Thank you.